Welcome to an exciting journey uncovering the mysteries behind Earth's land and water distribution. In today's video, we'll delve into the captivating world of plate tectonics, exploring the forces that shape our planet's landscapes. Ever wondered why Earth's surface is predominantly water, with land covering just a fraction of the total area? Join us as we unravel the answers to these questions and more, diving deep into geological time, shifting continents, and the dynamic processes that have sculpted our world. So, buckle up and prepare for an awe-inspiring adventure into the geological marvels that make our planet truly unique. Earth's formation and the origin of water. Our story begins about 4.6 billion years ago, when Earth formed from cosmic dust and debris left over after the sun's birth. As these particles coalesced, gravity triggered a heating and differentiation process, resulting in Earth's core, mantle, and crust. But where did all the water come from? Scientists believe that Earth's water has two primary sources: comets and asteroids, and volcanic activity. Water-rich comets and asteroids bombarded early Earth, releasing water upon impact. Additionally, water vapor trapped in Earth's mantle escaped through volcanic activity, eventually condensing into liquid water on the surface. As Earth's crust cooled and solidified, water began accumulating, forming vast oceans. Earth's early atmosphere was also crucial for water retention. Composed primarily of hydrogen, helium, water vapor, and other volatile gases, the early atmosphere created a greenhouse effect that kept surface temperatures warm enough for liquid water to exist. As water vapor condensed, the first rain fell, and rivers and lakes began to form, laying the groundwork for life on our planet. Plate tectonics and the distribution of land and water. Plate tectonics is the driving force behind Earth's dynamic landscape, shaping the distribution of land and water on our planet. The Earth's outermost layer, the lithosphere, is composed of rigid plates that float atop a more fluid layer called the asthenosphere. The lithosphere is broken into several major and minor tectonic plates, which move due to the convective forces generated by the Earth's mantle. These plates can either converge, collide, diverge, move apart, or slide past one another, causing various geological phenomena. One such phenomenon is continental drift, proposed by Alfred Wegener in 1912, which explains how continents have changed positions over time. About 200 million years ago, Earth's landmasses were joined together in a supercontinent called Pangaea. Tectonic forces caused Pangaea to break apart, giving rise to today's continents. The role of plate tectonics in shaping landmasses is evident in the formation of mountain ranges, ocean trenches, and the opening and closing of ocean basins. A critical process contributing to Earth's ever-changing landscape is subduction, which occurs when one tectonic plate slides beneath another, often resulting in the formation of mountain ranges and volcanic arcs. For example, the Andes Mountains were formed due to the subduction of the Nazca Plate beneath the South American Plate. These geological processes constantly reshape Earth's surface, impacting the distribution of land and water. In addition to tectonic processes, natural forces like erosion and sedimentation significantly influence Earth's surface. Erosion is the gradual wearing away of Earth's surface due to natural processes like water, wind, and ice. Eroded materials are transported and eventually deposited elsewhere as sediments, contributing to the formation of new landforms such as deltas and coastal plains. These processes can significantly alter the shape and size of continents, which in turn affects the distribution of land and water on Earth's surface. Throughout Earth's history, sea levels have risen and fallen due to factors like ice ages, glacial retreats, and tectonic activity. For instance, during the last ice age, sea levels were much lower than they are today, exposing vast areas of continental shelves that are now submerged. These fluctuations in sea levels have a direct impact on the distribution of land and water, altering coastlines and the extent of land masses. The constant movement of tectonic plates causes the continents to change shape and size over time. As plates collide, rift, or slide past one another, land masses can grow, shrink, or merge. The resulting changes in the distribution of land and water on Earth's surface are evident in the formation of new coastlines, islands, and other landforms. This dynamic interplay between tectonic forces, erosion, sedimentation, and sea level changes shapes the unique distribution of water and land that we observe today. Factors affecting the distribution of water and land. Numerous factors influence Earth's water and land distribution. One such factor is gravity. Earth's rotation generates a slight equatorial bulge, causing an uneven distribution of water across the globe. Additionally, the gravitational pull of the moon and the sun creates ocean tides, affecting water distribution along coastlines. Climate and weather patterns also significantly impact the distribution of water and land. Global atmospheric circulation drives air mass movements, which in turn influence precipitation patterns and water distribution on Earth's surface. Ocean currents, powered by temperature and salinity gradients, redistribute heat and moisture around the planet, affecting water distribution and shaping coastal landforms. Another critical factor is the composition and thickness of Earth's crust. Continents consist of lighter, less dense rocks like granite, allowing them to float higher on the denser mantle beneath. This process, known as isostasy, helps maintain the balance between land and water on Earth's surface. Ocean basins also play a significant role in determining the amount of water on Earth's surface. The size and depth of ocean basins control the volume of water they can hold. Tectonic processes, such as seafloor spreading and subduction, contribute to the formation and expansion of ocean basins, which directly impacts the distribution of water on Earth. The future of Earth's land and water distribution. As we look towards the future, we can make predictions about the distribution of land and water based on current geological trends. For instance, the ongoing movement of tectonic plates will continue to shape the continents and create new ocean basins. However, human activity, such as groundwater extraction, land use changes, and climate change, can also influence Earth's land and water distribution. Understanding the complex interplay between Earth's geological processes, climate, and human activity is essential for managing our planet's resources. As water scarcity becomes an increasingly pressing issue, we must develop sustainable solutions to ensure a stable supply of fresh water for future generations. Additionally, mitigating the effects of climate change will be crucial for preserving the delicate balance between land and water on Earth. To further complicate matters, the melting of polar ice caps due to global warming has the potential to dramatically alter the distribution of water on Earth. Sea levels are projected to rise substantially in the coming centuries, which could lead to the flooding of coastal areas and the disappearance of some low-lying islands. Adapting to these changes and managing Earth's resources responsibly will be of paramount importance for the survival and well-being of future generations. In this video, we've taken an in-depth look at why there is more water than land on Earth. We've explored the formation of our planet, the origin of water, the role of plate tectonics in shaping landmasses, and the various factors that influence the distribution of water and land. As we've seen, Earth's systems are interconnected, and understanding these complex processes is crucial for managing our planet's resources and ensuring a sustainable future. Thank you for joining us on this fascinating journey through Earth's history and geology. We hope you've learned something new and are inspired to continue exploring the wonders of our planet. If you did, then feel free to smash the like button and subscribe to our channel. Until next time, stay curious.